the northern Pacific sea star is posing significant threat to southern Australian waters. This is due to its impact on native marine ecosystems and industry. This sea star can grow up to 50 centimetres in diameter, is mainly yellow and often has purple or red markings. At any given time, as many as 10,000 different species are being transported in ships' ballast tanks. Most of these die in the dark and dirty conditions, but not the northern Pacific sea star. This is how it was introduced to Australia from its native northern Pacific home. There are more than 250 introduced marine species that have been identified in Australia. 150 of these are found in Port Phillip Bay. Whilst many become just another part of the flora and fauna, some like the northern Pacific sea star do not. This marine pest was first reported in Tasmania in 1986, and the first reported specimen in Port Phillip Bay was found by a fisherman at Point Cook in 1995. The sea star's population grew to 12 million in the 2 years after it was first confirmed in the bay. The northern Pacific sea star is able to reproduce into large populations quickly. Females can produce up to 20 million eggs each year, and the starfish are fast growing. They can also reproduce asexually, regrowing an entire body from a single arm and part of the central disc is still attached. The northern Pacific sea star is currently only found in Tasmanian and Victorian waters, but could quickly spread along the southern coast of Australia. In May 2012, 96 sea stars were found in Wilson's Promontory's Carter River. These were removed by divers in an attempt to avoid the spread into the national park. This marine pest has detrimental effects on native marine organisms. It is a vicious predator and feeds on native species. Their diet consists mainly of shellfish, such as oysters, scallops, and mussels. Studies have shown that Australian scallops do not elicit any of the escape responses they use against native sea stars when encountering the northern Pacific sea star. This suggests that they do not recognise it as a predator. The spotted handfish, found only in the Derwent River, is now considered to be vulnerable to extinction, and the northern Pacific sea star is listed as a possible cause as it feeds on its eggs. In Japan, the sea star costs the local shellfish industry millions of dollars annually, and this is with the numbers kept under control by other marine parasites. One of these parasites was introduced into Australian waters, but had little effect on the local population. In 1993, divers removed 30,000 sea stars from the Derwent River. This also had little impact. Removal also poses disposal problems. How do you dispose of the 30 million plus population of northern Pacific sea stars? Introduced plants and animals are a serious threat to global biodiversity, second only in importance to habitat loss. And the northern Pacific sea star is among the world's 100 worst invaded and one of the 10 most damaging domestic target species of the CSIRO. The CSIRO established the Centre for Research on Introduced Marine Pests in 1994 in an attempt to control the invasion. They also developed a technique to test ballast water for the presence of the species. However, the testing process was too slow and ships could not wait for the result. A study was undertaken into management options. The report details three proposed options: ballast water management, genetic control, and physical removal. Another study showed that mandated ballast water exchange on all ships reduced the likelihood of new invasions. The sea star's larval duration of 100 days plus means they can survive long journeys in ballast tanks. Genetic control and physical removal were deemed unsuitable as they can limit the spread, but removal of 100% of the population is required, and this would be impossible. In order to have any impact on the spread of the northern Pacific sea star, two complementary approaches are required: a global approach to slow the rate of invasion through ballast water, and a regional approach to develop and apply control options. The federal government endorsed a $5 million management plan to address the threat of the northern Pacific sea star, but as yet there is no conclusive data into the impact or the costs involved.